is set for one fall and is the main event. And is a three-way match. Introducing first, from Entremundo, Drago.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event on Lucha Underground, where we will premiere for you three of the most athletically gifted luchadors in the world. Some of them debuting for the first time on U.S. soil. Feast your eyes on Drago.
Brother, if you go to Mexico City and you check out the Pyramid of the Sun, when the sun sets at a certain hour in the day, a serpent slowly comes down the stairs. But Drago, show that tongue, man. Damn fresh. Gene Simmons, maybe?
And from Jalapa, Veracruz, Mexico, Pentagon Jr.
Matt, I want to quickly point out that in Mexico City and Lucha Libre, you always have the yin and the yang. There's Octagon and then there's Pentagon. They have the good and the bad. And this is something that's very classic for Lucha Libre, to have the dark side of a character, of a traditional Lucha Libre luchador.
And finally, from Mexico City, Mexico, Phoenix.
Apparently, Matt, this is the future of Lucha Libre in the United States and the world.
Yes, well, of course, visa clearances for all three luchadors, which means we will be seeing them more and more on Lucha Underground. And Vampiro, triple threat rules. This is different than a traditional match. Yep. All three luchadors can be at the ring at the same time. One pinfall will win this match. Disqualifications and countouts are referee Rick Knox's discretion.
No friends, no enemies. Just three guys that want to make an impression. And I'm telling you right now, that tongue, Drago made an impression on me.
Now, some people call this match a three-way dance, but the term triple threat just seems to be far more dangerous.
Matt, he got spun around by that kick.
Here we go, Pentagon. Oh!
It's every man for himself, evidently.
All three of these luchadors will enjoy a fast-paced, high-flying style. Right now, it seems that Pentagon
firing up.
Bang! Keep your eye on Drago. Now, of course, the luchadors will not work together. Wow!
Man, but watch what's coming, Matt.
Oh!
The fans don't even know what to make of this.
And now it's time, evidently, for the Phoenix to rise from the ashes here in the Temple of Lucha Underground.
Nice!
That was called an 875 corkscrew twist from the top. Straight to the floor, Matt. I don't know if you've ever seen that before.
I've seen it now.
Drago looks kind of fired up. I don't know if he's hurt, if he's getting ready to rock and roll.
Well, we'll try to keep track of the injuries and the collateral damage that's done to each luchador as the match goes on to give you a better gauge on who may be victorious. Right now, Phoenix in the ring with Drago.
Wow, kick to the chin. Wow, leg sweep. Very huge defensive maneuver in the martial art of Hapkido straight from Korea.
Notice how Phoenix cuts the ring off. Wow. Lends itself to Phoenix's speed. Drago seems to be slightly shorter, but perhaps a little more quick. Or quicker, pardon me.
Wow, my God. What would you call that, Matt?
Tilt-A-Whirl DDT.
You're quick tonight, brother.
Pentagon Jr. and Drago in now. Nice little Tanahashi there.
Pentagon signals that he has no fear. Cero miedo.
Can you please tell me how fresh it is that Lucha Libre comes from Mexico, but almost everybody has an Oriental theme?
Well, I think that fighting and wrestling is universal. It's worldwide. Of course, the popularity of MMA and pro wrestling, puro wrestling, Lucha Libre, world of sport, whatever you're into, enjoy Lucha Underground.
Wow. That's right. Call for it. You deserve it, brother. The crowd is on its feet.
Get a shot of Phoenix's chest. There is a dream catcher tattooed above his heart. I'm sure there's significance there.
Here comes Phoenix with a head of steam.
Wow!
devastating. For a guy that size to be moving that quick, Miller.
And of course, remember that when the luchadors are outside the ring, they're still not safe because of the aerial abilities of these world-class athletes.
And three SIE kicks to the back, to the midsection.
Wow, nice.
Jesus.
If I could physically do that, I would steal that move. Michinoku driver knocks down just a two count.
The only thing that wasn't modified that, brother, was his spine going through his upper cranium.
Listen to the people, the faithful in the temple.
I haven't seen you that freaked out in a long time, brother. You're chipping.
All three luchadors down. Referee Rick Knox starts the count. If no luchador reaches their feet before 10, the match is ruled a no contest. I'd hate to see that happen.
Brother, and the fans are chanting Lucha, only here on the LA Network and La Lucha Underground, in the temple of Lucha Libre.
That's worldwide. Right.
There you go.
Go to LRAYNetwork.com, type in your zip code. You'll find the channel on your cable provider. You don't want to be left out when everyone's talking about Lucha Underground.
You'll only see this kind of wrestling action right here.
Banderas onto the apron. Keep your eye on Drago. Little shades of Dr. Wagner there by Phoenix.
Oh, man.
Oh, this doesn't bode well for Dragon. Drago. No,
that was like, please don't. Oh, man, something not good. Oh.
Well, the anticipation builds.
Oh, man.
And Drago's still in the wrong part of town. Phoenix seems to be the fan favorite here.
I think that everybody here has pretty much gained fan favoritism.
Oh, wow, beautifully done.
Here we go. Is it going to happen?
Out. Roll through, roll back. Oh, that backstabber. Beautiful sequence.
I felt that myself.
And this is the action you get when three luchadors are in the ring at the same time.
The top talent in the world right here in front of us, Matt.
And Phoenix seems to be ascending the walk of faith. Of course, nothing is off limits here in the temple.
Pentagon and Drago both willing the crowd to get behind them.
Drago off the ropes. Big chop by Pentagon.
Another monster chop from Pentagon.
Drago using his speed as well as his hips. It seems that Drago seems to enjoy an athletic advantage over Pentagon. Whoa! Look at that!
That dragon can fly.
Hang on a second. Phoenix perched high atop the temple.
Pause. Man, that's got to be 30 feet up there.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Lucha Underground.
30-foot drop. With no regard for his body, no regard for his back, for his knees. Oh, my God.
A beautiful sacrifice by the Phoenix.
Off the hook.
Phoenix can barely rise to his feet. Did Phoenix sacrifice just a little too much to try to win this match?
Yeah.
The crowd is on their feet showing their appreciation for these three men. And Pentagon joins his opponents now. One of these three luchadors will walk out of this match with a huge victory tonight. The question, who's it gonna be?
Pentagon now with Dragon. Muscle buster time perhaps. Wow, package pile driver. Could this be it? No.
Oh man.
Oh. Oh, nice kick check there, just kicking the ankle.
Wow! What the hell was that?
Reverse Rana, referee knocks down, 2-3!
And your winner is... Phoenix!
Phoenix, cool
Phoenix, as well as Drago and Pentagon Jr. What a main event, a triple threat match here on Lucha Underground. Phoenix victorious with what I can only call a reverse Huracanrana pile driver brainbuster, question mark?
I think I'm gonna go for the question mark, Matt.
Okay.
After jumping off 453 feet in the air.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we had a huge triple threat match as our main event. We saw Mil Muertes continue his path of rage, and we heard from Chavo Guerrero Jr. Lucha Underground is certainly getting interesting.
Brother, you can see this is our main event and the crowd giving a standing ovation.
Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for joining us once again. We'll see you next week right here on the El Rey Network. This is Lucha Underground.
Want El Rey on your big screen? Visit ElReyNetwork.com. Enter your zip code to find El Rey in your area on any of these fine carriers. Or contact your cable company and say, I want to ride with El Rey.